Hello guys, on this video I want to present you how to hook an equalizer with an ampli tuner. So this ampli tuner is a Pioneer S6-1250, and this equalizer is a graphic equalizer from Pioneer, and the name is LG. So this equalizer is connected on tape monitor number 1. I will show you how to connect on tape monitor number 1, tape monitor number 2, and on the adapter switch. So you see how it looks here. Here is the power on off button. You can press and switch on and off, and the equalizer button, yeah? So now the equalizer it's connected. So let's discuss a little bit the sound, how is going the sound. So my sound is coming from the computer, is passing the sound card, and from the sound card it's coming on the auxiliary input of this receiver. From the receiver, the signal is going through this tape monitor number one, and the signal is going to the rack. Rack is going inside of equalizer on the rack input, and after that from the equalizer the signal is going out from play output, and the play output is coming on the play input inside of this ampli tuner, and from ampli tuner the signal is going on the preamplification section, and behind of Pioneer S6-1250 you have the pre out and power in, where is the bridge. And after that the sound is going and it's amplified to the speakers. The speakers which we have now and we are listening from them are the Monitor Audio MR6 3-ways speakers. And now with the equalizer you can play how you want, yeah? But we'll discuss later on after we will see the connections. So let's look for the connections behind. So now we are behind. We have here the tape number 1 rec and play. And on equalizer we have equalizer and tape. Because you are using this for inputs and outputs with this section, that means on this section you'll have connected the equalizer. So in case if you'll have two tape decks, to not lose one of them, you can connect the tape deck here, but this is another discussion. So to connect the equalizer with your receiver, ampli tuner, power amplifier, or up to you what you want to connect, you have to use two pairs of cables, yeah, RCA cables, and you'll connect. So the signal when you'll press the tape monitor number 1, when you'll connect it, the output from signal from a receiver is coming from rec. So it's exactly like you want to rec on a tape, yeah? So the signal is coming here. So I will connect a pair of RCA cables. So you see, black down, red up, yeah? So I suggest to you to make same. So you see, it's a whole entire cable, yeah? And this output from receiver I will connect on the input recording on equalizer, yes? So this one down and this one up. Okay, so now I have the input from receiver, input on equalizer, and now the sound have to come back from equalizer on the output, and we'll connect the output with input or play of cassette deck, yeah, tape 1. Okay, so red up. Okay, and black down. So we made the connection like that, and now we'll connect the cables on inputs on play, yes? So red up and black down. So now we connect the equalizer proper with the receiver. So here are the cables. Now let's play on the front and we'll make some audio tests, yeah? Okay, so now after we make the connection behind, so in this moment the sound is coming from sound card on the auxiliary input, and it's bypassing the tape monitor, yeah? Now if you want to listen on the equalizer, you have to put one on the equalizer, on the monitor number 1, yeah? And you can feel the difference now, yeah? So now it's on, off, on, off, on. But you can play also here, you see, on this equalizer. And now you can play up how you want with all the settings, yeah? So for this equalizer you see you have 60, 150, 400, 1000, 200, 4000, 400, 2400, 6000 and 15000, yeah? you have all the settings to play with them. So now I want to show you how to connect this equalizer on the adapter, yeah, because also we have a connection behind for the adapter. So let's come back again and we'll connect to the adapter. So now the tape monitor, it's on off position. So now you remember how we put the cables here. So the play, it's exactly the output of the equalizer, yeah? You can see here on top, rec and play. So this blue, it's output. So we'll take the output from here and we'll connect on in on adapter, yeah? Also for the right channel, input on out and input on out. Yeah, and now you have the connection made for the adapter, and after this we'll connect also for the tape number 2. Let's see on the front how it is. So you see now the signal is passing to auxiliary input, and if you press the tape monitor now, it will be in mute, yeah, because you will disconnect the signal on the preamplifier. So you'll leave the tape monitor on position and you'll have here the adapter knob. Pay attention. You see? So the result, it's very, very clear. Yeah? So on, off. On, off. And you can play also from this button here if you want. So you see now is no any connection. Yeah? And here you'll have the settings in case if you'll connect to equalizer the tape deck, you'll play on these buttons, yeah, tape, EQ, rec and equalizer, yeah. And you have also to have the adapter on position, of course, like now, yeah. So this is how it's going with equalizer. It's very simple to add an equalizer. It's very simple to add an equalizer, to hook an equalizer for a receiver. And it's similar also for the amplifiers, preamplifiers, depends of the connections, yeah? You have more ways of connections. You can, example, like, you can put the equalizer between input of your sound card and your receiver. I want to show you now how you'll change the equalizer from the adapter to the tape 2. We'll play on tape 2 and after that we'll connect. I will show you the connection between sound card and equalizer and after that the receiver. So let's go on to make that. So now the adapter is bypassed. It's on off position, so the signal is not coming here. So I will not disturb the sound here, yeah? So again, take out these connections, connect on the tape 2 on rec. Yeah, so this is the input from input in equalizer, yes, and output from receiver, and this is the output from equalizer, this, and it will be input on receiver. So let's test on front to see what we did. So now we are on the front, we'll test the tape 2 monitor, yes? Let's see. It's changing the music. So okay, now it's on off. Now it's on. Yeah, pay attention. You see how it's increasing the heights? Yeah, so it's working. So now I want to show you the last option, which I can show you now. We'll connect the equalizer between the sound card and the amplituner, and you'll see what's going on. Huh? You are curious? So if you are curious, please thumb subscribe, touch subscribe, thumb up, share with others, leave questions, put feedbacks, of course. Okay, so let's do it. If you like this kind of video, watch it more. But to be able to do this, we have to disconnect the sound card from the auxiliary input, yes? So if we'll do this, we have to change the input of the preamplifier because we'll create plenty noises, yeah? So I will put on FM and you'll hear a hiss. I will reduce the volume because I will not, I can't tune on a station, but it will be copyright claim. So we'll play like that and we'll change the connections and I will show you how I will do. So the idea is very simple. So the output of sound card You see, it's going on the auxiliary input. Correct? Correct. We have to take out this one from auxiliary input and we'll insert on the input on equalizer, yeah? So we'll put input of equalizer, we'll put the output from the sound card, yeah? So the sound card now have the output on input of equalizer. From equalizer we have the output, yeah? And we'll disconnect these cables because we don't need any more here. It was from previous setup. And now we have these color cables, which there are output from equalizer, we'll install on auxiliary input, yeah? So we have black down and red up, yes? Correct. Like that. So the signal now is coming from sound card, is going in equalizer here, and the output from equalizer is coming on these blue cables and is going on the auxiliary input. So let's see what we did. So what do you think it's working? So let's see. Auxiliary. Wow, we have sound, yeah, you see? And this one is switched off. So we have to switch on and we have to push the equalizer, yeah? Wow, so you see, it's not necessary to have tape monitor one, tape monitor two, or an adapter to be able to connect an equalizer, yeah? So you can do very simple. You see, here is the sound card, I can play the volume how I want. So I did this connection with you, so it's possible to do also like that. If it's working, let's see. So I can say it's working, yeah? You see? So it's not necessary to have tape deck. You can insert the equalizer between your audio output, I don't know, Bluetooth, I don't know, USB player, it's up to you what you have, yeah? Tape deck, doesn't matter. And your preamplifier. So, and it will work, yeah? So let's try one more time, you see, the heights are on maximum now. So adapter, you see, is nothing there, yeah? Tape deck, tape monitor is nothing there. Tape monitor one, it's nothing there. So it's clear, yeah? So it's working like that. You can hear the differences. So it's really, really clear. And of course, in this way, you can use also your tone controls. It's no any problem, yeah? You see, you have a lot of height. Yeah? So this is how it's going. So it's possible everything, depends what you want and how you connect. So thank you for your attention. On this video you saw how to connect an equalizer with an amplituner or receiver or amplifier, how to connect on tape monitor 1, tape monitor 2 or adapter, or you, if you don't have this, you can connect between the source of signal and your audio equipment. So thank you for your time. If you like this kind of content, don't forget to subscribe, thumb up, leave comments, share with others. And like I said on the beginning, I will attach also here the sound card to see what is the model, how it's working, how I connect, and how I will set with computer. Yeah. So thank you for your time. Cheers, guys. All the best. See you.